You may remember me. I was here a few months ago to talk to you about we had to adjust the mass schedule due to the construction noise in the lower church. The construction is going along very well, and now we are entering our next phase. And with the next phase, a few major things are going to happen. One, the boiler. There's one boiler that's housed in the school that services the school, the convent, the church, and the rectory. Very inefficient. As you know, the school and the convent are not used. So right now, the boiler has to come offline. They've been working in the lower church to create that space for the new boiler, and now they're beginning to do that work. The engineers have told us we have to take the boiler offline in order to now move those pipes, and there's going to be steam piping put in. So that's one major thing that's going to be done. Second, over here where the sacristy is going, the walls are going to come down. The sacristy is going to be moved possibly to this side of the sanctuary. With that, there's asbestos in the walls. This is a very old building, a very beautiful building. But with that, now there's an air quality hazard here. And if you've ever seen asbestos removal in the city, it's a major ordeal. And it takes quite some time. So those are the major things. Along when you begin any construction in one of our churches, the city has codes, but most of our churches are grandfathered in until we begin to do work, and then we need to adhere to those codes. One of them is that, again, back here, we need to create another exit for the church. We have an exit on this side, but we need to create another one. And there are other issues that we need to do to get up to code. As a result of this next phase, unfortunately, the engineers have told us we need to close the church for a few months. The local churches have been made aware that they will welcome you. Guardian Angel, Holy Innocents, Holy Cross, St. John the Baptist, St. Francis of Assisi, our Savior. I'm not quite sure, but one of the main questions is how long is that going to be? And we're not quite sure. As you know, when you begin to do this kind of intensive work, they cannot give you a date of when this exactly, but we will certainly keep in touch with you. The Cardinal asked me to come here today to assure you we are investing in St. Michael's. We are doing all this work because we are investing in the future of St. Michael's. We look at St. Michael's as a significant parish in this part of the west side of Manhattan. One of the major complaints that a lot of our parishes have is that they have no gathering space. St. Michael's in the lower church is the length of this church, so there is a lot of gathering space. And it would be seen as that on the west side of Manhattan. So please know, St. Michael's is not closing. We are investing in the future, and we hope for this parish to be here for many centuries after. So thank you for your time this morning. I will be in the back of the church if you have any questions, and I'm happy to answer them. Thank you.
Sincerely, we thank the Vice Chancellor and we ask her to convey our deep greetings in the very high ranking Archbishop Conrad Gordon. He's a great friend of ours. I don't know if he has forgotten me, I think he knows me personally. My special greetings. My dear boy, she was just telling us that there is hope. I nearly jumped from my seat when he says, St. Michael's continues to exist. So we are only repairing, and we shall continue to be till the end of time. Thank you. I shall also see at the back of the church at the end. Thanks everybody for your donations. Keep up. That's good. That's wonderful. Reliance in God. Thank you.
Make you go ahead and citizens of heaven through Christ.